David, ultimately a defeat tonight, but a performance that you must be proud of.
Yes, over the course of the game, I thought we'd done really well. Disappointing, obviously, to lose a goal and stuff like that. You know, I thought we started the second half pretty well. First half, we'd done really well defensively and, you know, attacking as well. We created a few opportunities. You know, Toddy was unlucky with one in the first half. But, you know, our reaction after the penalty was pleasing. You know, we came back in it straight away. We looked to get on the front foot again and we created a few opportunities and just unfortunate that we couldn't take them.
If Josh had taken that chance, potentially a whole different ball game.
Yeah, of course. You know, you take yourself into the lead and then it asks questions of hearts. You know, do they open up a bit and try and come at us a wee bit? Because I think over the course of the game, I can't remember too many chances that they created, so that's testament to, you know, Robbie in the back four, but also the rest of the team as well. We were patient in our shape at times, and, you know, we picked them off when they had the opportunity. Sorry.
Hearts, I mean, a big club, obviously, Premier League side, expected to come here and kind of stick a few in the net, but it must be encouraging from a Falkirk perspective how well your team basically stood toe-to-toe with them.
Yeah, Hearts have had a few kind of indifferent results recently and a few indifferent performances as well, and they changed again tonight, you know, three or four of their personnel, plus they changed their shape, so we knew that was going to be unsettling for them, and probably the first half would have been time to capitalise on that. But, you know... As you say, it's pleasing to see, you know, how well the boys done. You've still got to give them the due that, you know, Hearts are a Premier League team, and we're a couple of leagues down, but it shows how far the boys have came. So we said that to them. Yes, we're gutted that we're out the cup, but we take the positives from tonight's game and now we put our full focus into the league.
What's your thoughts on the penalty from where we were? Difficult to see, but did Michael get a touch on that?
I don't think so. I don't think there's any question about it. It's a penalty. And we said that, you know what I mean? There's no point dwelling over it. We said that and, you know, we move on for it. It's fine.
On another night, how unlucky were your side to hit the woodwork not once, not twice, but three times?
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. So those opportunities, you know, when you're on top, it's about taking those opportunities, especially in games like this where, you know, you might only get one or two opportunities, but, you know, with quite a few tonight, it's just unfortunate we never took them.
Important, though, to take, as you say, some positives and keep the belief going.
Yeah, of course, absolutely. You know, the boys have done well over the past few weeks and stuff. So, we take the positives from tonight and we kick on again. We've got another couple of big games coming up in the next few weeks, so we need to get our full focus on that. In a strange way, you might think, well, it's good that the cup run's not there because we can put our full focus into it. Yeah, we're gutted that we're out of the cup, but, you know, we need to now go and just focus on the league.
South Stand at one point with sort of 15 minutes to go chanting Lee Miller's name. You're going to have a word in his ear at some point and say, get on?
No, possibly. You know, we looked at just the way the game was going and, you know, we're trying to get a bit more foothold in the game because Hearts had a period where, you know, they showed their experience and they killed the game a wee bit. They kept the ball. You know, they slowed it down and stopped our momentum. So we tried to get a bit more legs on there to try and get down the sides of them and stuff like that again. So that was the kind of decision on the substitution. But it was fantastic to see the fans tonight, you know, coming out in their numbers. But not only that, coming out with the noise as well. It felt like, you know, times of old where, you know, you had the sing-song for the start of the game, which is brilliant and it helps the players. You know, it galvanises them and pushes them on during the game as well. So hopefully for now at the end of the season we can see some more of that.
Back to league matters now. Of course, it was all doom and gloom from some people last week after a 1-1 draw at Stranraer, but of course Raith Rovers going down in a similar result. Suddenly win the game in hand and it's back to a point.
Yes, yeah, absolutely. We were gutted with both the result and the performance. We knew we didn't play well, but it showed again, you know, that, you know, it's not going to be an easy place for teams to go to. You know, unfortunate for us that, you know, Stranraer get a draw today. So, yep, we focus on ourselves. We look at the next game coming up and we take the positives from tonight and we take that into the game.
And just finally on that game, East Fife here, I believe it's at home at the Falkirk Stadium. Mm-hmm. Your thoughts, can we do it?
Yeah, of course. We've got to, as I said, you know, we've got to now focus on the league and look to take full points out of every game. Whether that's, you know, going to happen or not, we'll see. But, you know, we'll take some of the stuff we've done tonight and the way we played and the aggression and, you know, we played with it in our pressing and stuff like that as well when we had the ball. And we'll take that into the league games and, you know, it should do us fine.
David, as always, thanks for your time.